As Casey was growing up, his parents instilled upon him the importance of a good, positive attitude and a belief in miracles. It's my pleasure now to introduce to you my friend and my protege, Casey Schallenberg.
Hello everyone, my name is Casey Schallenberg. I am a young boy, a child of God, to carry out God's will, and I am very, very thankful to see so many people here to listen to God's will. And I'm hoping to share my message and to also share my story to as many people as I can about never giving up. And also how important it is to have a great, faithful, positive attitude. I want people to live in prayers, healing, miracles, and God's love. I had a couple of miracles in my life that I would very much like to tell you about. My first miracle was surviving a very premature birth. I was born 13 weeks too early because my lungs weren't fully developed. This was the result of making me get a condition called cerebral palsy, but I survived, and I am very happy to be here. I was a twin, but God had a special plan for my sister in heaven. Her name is Kelsey. I believe my sister Kelsey watches over me. I thank God and Kelsey had led my parents' great dedication, determination, and many great things when it comes to taking care of me. My parents also taught me that life doesn't have to be perfect to be wonderful. My parents taught me to pray and believe in miracles. My parents helped me develop a great attitude, a stop at nothing, keep moving forward, I can do anything attitude. Also, remember when you pray and nothing seems to be happening? Remember that prayer is like planting a seed in the ground. For weeks and months you may see nothing, but a lot is happening underground. Keep on trusting God, as one day you will see the answer to your prayers. Just as one day you will see that plant grow. For many years, I could not walk. It really hurt to try to stand on my feet. I could not straighten my legs. I used to need a wheelchair all that time. My parents and I prayed and prayed. And finally, our prayers were answered 2 years ago when I was 9 years old and I walked for the very first time in my life. This miracle took a long time, a lot longer than a plant growing, but there were lots of things going on, like seed in the ground. God was leading my parents to find the best alternative therapies and the least invasive surgery. I was working hard and gaining strength for 9 years. God knew when I would be ready to walk, so that is when he answered our prayers. When I was first born, the doctors told my parents that I would never walk or talk. They told my parents to just take me home and love me and not to expect so much from me. My parents refused to believe that I would never walk or talk. Well, I proved the doctors wrong when I was not quite the age of 2 years old. I was good at a speech therapy. I talked really good. So good that I told the therapist that my legs were sticky. More recently, I even had a doctor tell me something not very smart about while the song says these boots are made for walking, my legs weren't made for walking. That really offended my heart. I mean, really. I never heard of that song before. I was even more offended that he referred to a song that was obviously before my time. The part about my legs just didn't bother me. I just told myself that coming this far, nothing is going to stop me now. I've since heard the song, by the way. My mom sometimes sings it to me while I'm walking and doing my exercise. I don't think it's a very good song, by the way, but then again, it could be the way my mom sings it. I want people to know that they should never give up faith. Some people lose faith when things get hard, and I'm here to restore that faith. If you believe in the Lord, He will be there for you and will answer your prayers. I know this because He answered my walking prayer, and I experienced my walking miracle. It also takes a good attitude and faith, and the urge to help yourself. I want to tell you about a fable that I read while doing my homeschoolwork. It's called Hercules and the Wagoner. It's about a farmer driving his wagon along a miry country road. After a heavy rain, the wheels of the wagon sank into a rut. The farmer was very angry with the wagon. He cursed at the wagon and yelled at it. Then, finally, he called loudly to Hercules to come to his aid. Hercules would not help the farmer unless he made some effort to help himself. Hercules told the farmer to put his shoulder on the wagon and urge on his horses. After that, the farmer was riding along in great content. So the fable tells us that we have to help ourselves. Heaven helps those who help themselves. My parents always taught me to help myself and work hard for what I wanted. They always tried to instill positive thoughts into my mind, to have great determination and a great attitude and faith. I feel very blessed, and I thank God every day for the meaning and goodness of life and fulfilling it with such a wonderful family and wonderful friends. I know God has a special plan for me, and He has a special plan for each and every one of you in this audience as well. Thank you, and I hope that you enjoyed listening to my story, and God bless you.